not the one who has to fix that mess. Take it easy.
My bad.
The leaders are pitting.
I am the one that pays for it, though. Hey gearheads, and welcome on back to the NASCAR Thunder 2003 Career Mode. I'm Alan Bailey. I don't want to talk about the last race. I'm still scratching my head over it. You could check out that video in the link above my head right. Meow. But yeah, race number 6, Food 7500 at Bristol. Bristol day race before they put dirt down on it, which is a thing we're going to be able to say in the near future. when everybody forgets that the spring race was ever on concrete. But let's go ahead and head on into team management. See, the sponsors aren't too happy with our finish from last week. All good, I guess. But yeah, let's go into the garage. We have to repair, to say the least. We gotta repair this guy. Actually, what we could do is overhaul. Let's overhaul this guy. Do we have the cash? Where's our cat? Yeah, that's gonna clear out our cash, but let's overhaul this engine. So you can see right now, car one is down for repair, to say the least, but we have a 100 car right here that has seen no race action. Overall, it's a 52, 51 on power, 52 efficiency, durability, e-durability, 53. It's 100% condition right now. Tire grip 52, tire wear 51, downforce 52, drafting 51. You can see by these numbers, we have a long way to go, but we're selecting car two, gonna be taking this out to Bristol. With that, we're gonna go ahead and head on out to Bristol for the Food City 500. Let's go.
Welcome everyone to Bristol, Tennessee for today's NASCAR Winston Cup race, the Food City 500, right here on MRN. Barney, this place has been referred to as the world's fastest half-mile oval. Add 43 cars to that, and you've got a recipe for some exciting racing.
Yeah, Joe, a lot of these teams don't like coming here too much. There isn't a whole lot of room out there, which usually leads to a week of work in the body shop. There probably won't be a single car at the end that doesn't have at least a scratch or two. Some gonna be much worse than that.
Kevin Harvick will try to use this race to gain a couple spots in the points.
He's been working hard this season, and it is paying off so far. He'll need a good finish in this one to gain some spots.
Casey Atwood has not had the finishes he's hoped for in the past couple races.
Oh, he definitely wants to turn things around starting now. His whole crew seems determined to pull out of this slump. I wouldn't be surprised if they pull off at least a top 15.
Bobby Hamilton finds himself in a bit of a slump.
He definitely needs a good finish, not just for himself, but for the team, his sponsors, and everyone else involved with that team.
For the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
The starting lineup.
In the front row are the two car and the sprint Dodge. In the second row are the 28 car and the Pennzoil Chevrolet. Starting the race from row three are the UAW Delphi Chevrolet and the UPS Ford. The fourth row has the Dodge Dealers UAW Dodge and the DeWalt Power Tools Ford. Starting the race from row five will be the BAM Racing Dodge and the Tide Ford. In row six we have the America Online Chevrolet and the Cheerios Dodge.
Get ready.
I'm ready.
Green, buddy. Go, go, go.
So, not a great qualifying effort. The car's just, yeah, it's tight. And I forgot to adjust it for the race, my bad. So we're gonna have a fun first half of the race here. but these 50 laps out here, it's going to go pretty quick, but, you know, I'm going to be pulling some pit strat here, trying to make up some of this ground, because I'm sick of running outside the top 10. Trying to diamond these corners like I have in other games.
We're just 4.5 seconds off the lead. Be patient.
Kind of, sort of works, but you can see right there, it's we don't get the drive off. Hi, Yami.
Number 48 is outside. Gained another spot.
Is that Shauna Robinson up there holding up this whole gaggle of cars? I think so.
Your pace is falling off. Pick it up a little.
Something I just remembered is that this is old school Bristol, so the bottom is literally the only way around this place. So I've been like searching mid, high, trying to find some grip. It's like, nah, ain't gonna work. Crew Chief is finding new ways to insult me. I'm trying to keep it off the wall. It is tight like there is no tomorrow. And trying not to do that because it's what DNF'd us last week, so.
Try working another line. We need to get back on pace.
Car is slow. Crew Chief, make car faster.
Fuel's down to
copy.
Head.
Gonna try to pit around lap 120, around lap 24 here, so in about 10 laps.
Okay, you got some driving to do. The leader has about 10 seconds.
Copy. Reason being is I want a short pit, try to make up some ground, and I think I'm only going to do two tires. Really, really, really play that strat.
Car 5. That's another in the rearview mirror.
Up to 14th, so slowly going in the right direction. And the leader's in massive traffic, so we gained a tiny bit of ground on him that last lap. But we're about half a second, or, ooh, we're about half a lap short, behind the leader.
Number 32, all over your back bumper. Race back to the line.
We got it, right?
Leader's interval is about 9
seconds.
Yeah,
we got it. What happened?
Take care of your car.
Did I do it?
We'll get him.
I did do it. Yeah, my hood came off. My bad. I'm thinking maybe, just maybe, I'm gonna get four tires and some adjustments right here under this caution and go from there. I don't foresee everybody ducking down pit road because you can't make it from here, but it sets me up for just a splash and go at the end of the race. So I'll buy it, you know, why not? Let's loosen this thing way up. Okay. So restarting in the back here.
There it is. Let's go.
I don't think we'll be able to make it, but if we get a caution here, we actually might be able to stretch it. Cuz we were going
to. Okay, you got some driving to do. The leader has about 10 seconds on us.
She's still real
we got
tight.
Some cars headed down pit road.
Yeah, we're going to try to stretch this fuel. We're going slow enough. We might be able to. Copy that.
There's still plenty of time to get to the front. Be
patient. I'm about to. Because we're up to fifth right now, so. I don't think we're going to steal a win, but I think we'll definitely have a good top 10, shot at a top 10 here.
About 9 seconds on us.
Copy that.
Okay, we're clear. Hey, you're not the one who has to fix that mess. Take it easy.
My bad.
Leaders are pitting.
I am the one that pays for it, though. In more ways than one, so, you know. And with that, we take over the lead. Curious to see where the intervals are.
All right, we picked up the 5 bonus points for leading the lap.
2 seconds back to... Who was that? Someone. It'll tell us the next time by, but...
Car inside.
Yeah, letting off here, trying to make it.
Okay,
because I think we're going to be maybe a lap short, give or take. Yeah, 30 car.
You can't win a race if there's no car to finish with.
Second place car has caught us. It's this 30 car. That 30 car.
Looks like some of the leaders are headed down pit road.
Okay, so we'll have even more of a lead then by the time this thing shakes out. Because there's only like. There's only a handful of cars on the lead lap. Ooh, hoo, 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 hoo. That'll help us. Oof. Ooh. That 25 car. Aww. So here comes the 25. Yeah. Bristol's nuts. Yes, actually, I'll pit.
Tires loose, get it on there.
At least it's under caution. But I, okay, we're down third, fourth. How many cars? Ooh, only five cars on the lead lap.
Green, green, green.
Right?
Okay, we're clear.
That's gotta be the case. So we might have a, we do have a shot at the top five here. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like five cars on the lead lap. Yeah, we're gonna be good. Why did I restart in the back though? Technically, I should have restarted up there with the rest of the field, right?
10 laps to go.
Copy that. The car just went straight right there. The only thing I'm really doing is riding. I'm trying to make sure that I don't lose a lap to the leader who's coming behind us a little bit. That's not him in 22, it's that blue one up there. So you know, if I just stay on the lead lap in case we get a restart here, we should be good. But we're looking at a top five here at Bristol.
Number 19 is looking to pass.
Ooh, we got a car blowing up. Ooh, it's Junior. Dale Jr. blowing up. Less than 10 to go at Bristol. Yikes.
Two to go. Let's finish strong.
Copy that. The leader just took the white. So do me a favor. Mash that subscribe button for our first top five here in the game. And also, my bad. Give us a thumbs up for, I guess, surviving Bristol is the only way to put it. Checkered flags out. And if you like the video, share it. Well, of course they are. Share the video with your friends and family and on your social media accounts to help grow the channel. Top five at Bristol, boys and girls.
Top five.
I'll take it. That was hard fought, and the hood was about to come off, but Rusty Walrus gets the victory out here. Whew.
The drivers didn't spend much time behind that Pontiac pace car today.
Well, I can assure you all those guys who finished in the back would like to have seen more cautions. Gives them a chance to make adjustments without the penalty of going a lap down. They just didn't have that luxury this time.
The 64 car didn't finish where he had hoped, due in part to the damage on his car, I'm sure.
Well, Joe, they're bound to have bad days in this NASCAR Winston Cup Series. The key is having a team that can put everything back together and continue forward at the same time. These guys will be fine.
Well, that's all the time we have today. Join us again for our next live broadcast of NASCAR Winston Cup Racing right here on the voice of NASCAR, MRN.
Really good little payday there for us. We needed that almost $400,000 right there. So Rusty, Ricky Rudd, Matt Kenseth, Jeff Green, ourselves, and Jeff Purvis got his lap back somehow. So they only six cars on the lead lap out here. We come out with a top five. That's pretty good. You see right there, Dale Jarrett, Jeff Gordon, Shauna Robinson, wow, and Tony Stewart with top 10s as well. So, interesting little stat there. Make sure that you give me a follow over on Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch at Hey Allen Bailey. You can also support the channel over on patreon.com/Hey Allen Bailey. Oh, Bristol, you were good to us. You could have been better to us, but you could have been a lot better to us. But I can't. In this car, I shouldn't complain about a top five, I guess. So, best finish of the career so far. You know, and we're only six races in, so that's not bad. That's not bad. For the NASCAR Thunder 2003 career mode, I'm Allen Bailey. We'll see you at the track.